So I have good news and bad news.
Okay.
The good news is I finally remembered to order some headphones.
Yay!
The bad news is they're coming tomorrow.
Ooh la la!
Yeah.
All right. Well,
next week.
I don't know if you noticed, I've been doing some stuff, at least on the recording, if y'all have been watching on YouTube, I've been cleaning up the audio a lot more. I hope you can tell there's a bit of a difference. It worked better, yes? No?
I think.
Yeah. Okay. So we've got a lot of Florida this week. Like a lot.
Laura, have been feeling a little left out.
Right? Like
ooh la la.
Florida missed us.
Were you scared we forgot about you? Because we didn't.
Florida, we could never forget you. You are America's Wang.
Did I coin that or did somebody else coin that? But I don't know where it came from.
I feel like it came from a song.
It's.
But I don't remember by whom.
Whoever came up with it, it's so true.
In more ways than one.
All right. Let's get intro going so that we can burrow
in. So I can read.
Intro. Each week, Catherine, Radio Data audience, go out the worldwide interwebs, find all sorts of horrible stuff, bring it back here for a little segment we like to call What the Fuck Is Wrong With You? And we're going to start with a super horrible thing because this could have gone so badly and I don't understand what the plan was here and there were minor injuries, but everybody's okay, thank God. And what the actual fuck? So we've got a... I'm going through a whole range of emotions here.
Yeah.
Arsonist lit home on fire and locked 21 people inside. Now, this isn't just some random shit. It gets worse. Like, you're sitting there going, how can...
I just watched this movie with Anya Taylor-Joy and Ralph Fiennes. Probably a spoiler.
Sorry. A Florida home was doused with gas on New Year's Day and set ablaze with 21 people locked inside. Oh, when you find out why, you're going to be like, what? Four were hurt as a group scrambled to escape through windows. Not life-threatening, just they were hurt, though, because there was... Happened at a home on London Lane in Bonita Springs, and a motive has not been released. Oh, we know. We'll get into why exactly. I know exactly why. Upon arrival, deputies learned prior to the fire, one man was wielding a machete inside the residence and threatening to kill people inside. He then began pouring gasoline through the residence while a second suspect set the fuel on fire. The two then left the residence, locking the door behind them. All 21 people inside escaped. Details of how the four were injured not been released, but investigators say they sustained injuries as a result of the fire. Kind of busted out. Two suspects, ages 42 and 63, were arrested during a search of the neighborhood. The 63-year-old suspect lives in the neighborhood, while the other man is from Tampa. I know exactly what fucking happened. This old son of a bitch was pissed at the New Year's party and he went total fucking Florida on them. That's what fucking happened.
With a machete?
With a machete and gasoline.
But also, not to be victim blamey, but when there's 20 of you and you see one guy pouring gasoline on your house, do you just stand there?
Well, he had a machete, though.
One guy has a machete.
Well, it's just like, you know, he can't cut all of us. I don't want to be the one of us that does get cut.
But also, like, do we know that the guy with the machete... Because one of them was pouring gasoline and the other one was lighting it. So both of them were preoccupied.
Maybe. Like,
and there are 20 of you.
I... 63. 63 is too old for those kind of shenanigans. Although, you know what? Like, trapping people inside a house, waving a machete and lighting on fire is... that's kind of just how they say hi down there.
And that's why we don't go there. Like, I've seen Disney a couple times. I'm good.
This fucking... how does your thought process go, this is a good idea. Nothing will go wrong with this. It's going to work out fine. Right now, they've been charged with arson and attempted assault. But you know what happens when you try to burn a building down with people inside it? That's a...
not attempted murder.
That's attempted murder, yeah.
So why is it just assault?
For now. You know, obviously, they get arrested for one thing, and then the attorney adds on... the prosecutor adds on charge. It's going to go up to attempted. This is going to be attempted. Because 21 people and your dumb ass...
Simba, where are you? Why are you just wandering around grunting at me?
Like, I have had, on occasion around here, there have been loud parties in my neighborhood. Quite often, they're loud shit. But on the occasions it was too much, I think it was a New Year's, it was either a New Year's or Christmas party that was a little too much. I had a show to do. I went outside, I walked over the house, and instead of waving a machete and gasoline, I said, hi, it's getting a little late. Would you mind turning it down some? And they did.
Wow. And you didn't even try to kill anybody?
I didn't try to kill anybody. I know. Crazy, right?
Weird.
You're 63 years old. This is the best you have to do. Like, I hope when I hit, like, my 60s, my 70s, with any luck, my 80s, I could find a hobby that doesn't involve a machete and arson.
It feels very much like if Edgar Allan Poe was a Floridian. Isn't it?
Yeah, it's like the Florida Cask of Amontillado.
Masquerade
Death or something, right? Yeah, it's kind of got that, only it's stupid.
Yeah.
Well, speaking of stupid, we have California for our next one. Don't worry, we're coming back. We won't stray far. But this next one is California, and it's also arson. Only it's a feel-good arson story. And I'll show you why. We got video. Let's go here first. Well,
feel-good arson story is not a phrase you hear every day.
So these two jackasses went to a business that provides services for... immigration services, and they're very white, as you can tell. And here they are, splashing accelerant all over the place. Now you might be saying, Dash, how is this feel good? This looks like it's going to be terrible. What's going to happen here? That's what's going to happen here. As they set they dumbasses on fire. That's what happened. Yes, exactly. He said,
"You didn't even think to draw a crow."
They're not.
Where is the craftsmanship?
No one watching this is going to get that reference, and it's sad. I know, but true. Arson.
The babies have seen that movie by now.
I don't think babies were watching The Crow.
Well, they should be.
Arson is seen pouring gas on business and catching themselves on fire. Two people tried to set an immigration service building on fire in California and ended up setting themselves on fire in the process. Just after midnight, Monday, January 2nd, authorities received multiple reports of a fire at a commercial building in Bakersfield. When firefighters got there, they found a fire in the garage or the back of the building. Within 10 minutes, they were able to declare a knockdown of the fire. Quick knockdown of the fire, limited fire damage to the garage. They learned the business is a tax preparation company. Firefighters helped the property owner move important documents to a secure area. Servicio de Immigración posted a surveillance footage of it. Can we see it again? Let's watch that again. 'Cause
Was it an immigration office or a tax office? I'm confused.
Yes, they do services for immigration. For
okay.
Yeah.
These are two people actually stupid enough to not be Proud Boys, apparently.
And they said, see, what's going to happen is, you've kind of, what you've done to yourself, the fire, the burns, we call that evidence. I don't want to get too technical on you. I want to keep this in layman's terms, but we call that evidence for a court of law.
Because you're probably going to need medical attention.
Right? You dumb sons of bitches. Kern,
be a little careful. You don't just do because then you're getting the accelerate on you.
What? Farrah, why do you want to help them?
Yes, I don't understand. Like, I know people are fucking stupid by now. I'm aware. But you'd like to think that at some point, some, like, caveman self-preservation instinct would kick in, and you'd think, gosh, maybe I shouldn't splash the gasoline all over my fucking self if I'm about to light it.
Part of it was they knew a camera was there, so they were trying to be all tough and hard and shit. Like, yeah, fuck you. Fuck. And then, whoosh.
Shit.
Like, if you're going after an immigration office, people help immigrants with fire, you're not a very bright person to start with. Let's be perfectly honest. You're
also not a good person.
No. Yeah. So no one feels bad that you cost your dumb asses on fire. No one does. And they're going to find you because you caught your own dumb asses on fire.
Because if you don't want to die of a terrible infection, you're going to have that looked at.
And for those of you out there who are near Kern County, if you would like to give information on these two dumbasses that nobody likes that set themselves on fire, you can call 1-877-FIRE-TIP. That's a real number. Give them a call if you know anything about these two dumb motherfuckers who deserve to be on fire.
Like a medical problem?
Fire tip, yeah. Well, you know, they might be experiencing that themselves right now, so.
That sounds like something you'd actually use that Roman website for. Which, I have to say, like, it's now just Ro, because they have women's stuff too, and you can tell I'm itchy because I'm scratching. I get eczema from them, and it's very convenient and easy. So they don't just do dick pills. Just in case you were wondering.
It's a tangent right there. So back to Florida. We've often said, and often had to remind people out there, I'm sure someone watching this may have been dissuaded. We've had to tell you that 911 is not customer service. If even one person who watches this show has said to themselves, maybe I shouldn't call 911. I feel like we've accomplished something. These people did not do that. And this is, without a doubt, one of the all-time dumbest of 911 is not customer service. Burglars called 911 to get help moving stuff.
Duh.
Two people in Florida were arrested after one of them made a 911 call to get help with moving their belongings from a home they were burglarizing.
Shut the fuck up.
Poinciana, Florida. Two people in Florida were arrested after one of them made a 911 call to get help with moving their belongings from a home they were burglarizing.
So was it their belongings?
Yeah, I mean, really? Yeah. Deputies responded to a home Saturday after a 911 call was made, but nobody spoke. At the home, deputies concluded nobody lived there, but they found a male suspect and his girlfriend inside the home after entering it through an unlocked door. Deputies have been searching for the male suspect after identifying him from the security video as a burglar at a Dollar General store in Poinciana, Florida. Several items were stolen earlier in the day. While talking to deputies, the female suspect told them she had called 911 for the purpose of having law enforcement help them move their belongings from the house they were burglarizing. They also wanted to get a ride to the airport so they could spend the weekend in New York.
Like, literally none of that is the job of the cop.
This is the first time you've had a story that I got up from the I stopped what I was doing and came in here because I'm like, I did not hear that. I heard
that. None of that is the, even if you hadn't stolen a bunch of shit, none of that is the job of the cops.
That is not their job.
I went to ride home from the airport after Christmas. So you know what I did? I got a fucking Uber.
Not Abby in the channel goes, really? Dollar General? All right, number one, I don't know why that's the part you're singling out, but two, yeah, I mean, of all the places to, if you're gonna be, like, shoplifting, the Dollar General.
If you're gonna steal the bank.
Right? Don't steal, like, the knockoff sugar smacks from the
don't
Dollar
General. You're not paying. Fuck it, go to Whole Foods.
Male suspect was charged with burglary and theft, and a female suspect was charged with burglary of a residence. Yeah, if you are doing the crimes and you call the police, the police only help with their own crimes, not yours. Okay? I mean, I know how you might have gotten confused because they help other cops with crimes all the time. But that's other cops. If you want
they're
the cop
to help you move.
Right, they're not going to help you move. Unless you're another cop and it's illegal, then they'll help you. If you want the cops to help you with crime, become a cop.
I had a cousin who unfortunately passed away, but he owned a moving business and then became a cop. So he might help you move. But it wouldn't be related.
I just love the fact that she thought, oh, and while you're at it, can you take us to the airport? We got a bash we got to attend in New York. You don't mind, right?
If you get those boxes while you're at it, no.
Well, speaking of police committing crimes. Here we go. This motherfucker. Oh, okay. So I don't, a lot of the time, police officers, when they're off duty, they'll moonlight as security at various places.
Yeah.
It's correct. In fact, they have like rules. Yeah, they have a lot of, they actually have rules about how long they're allowed to do this. It's like in lieu of overtime or maybe maybe they double book it or whatever. I don't know. This motherfucker, though, what the fuck? Moonlighting.
Hang on a sec.
What?
Can you hear that?
A little bit.
Oh. Or louder. Don't leak the mic. Can I hear it? He's a licker. He licks things. I don't know why.
Moonlighting Snohomish County deputy resigns after being charged with organized retail theft. The deputy worked as a security guard at Home Depot. He's accused of stealing more than $1,000 worth of merchandise. It's from Washington State. A now former Snohomish County deputy charged with organized retail theft after allegedly stealing from a South Everett Home Depot over the course of several weeks. Jeremy Zeller, 46, was moonlighting as a security guard at the store. Accused of collecting various items from around the store and placing them at the front, where he told co-workers he would pay for them before he left. Prosecutors say surveillance video shows him walking out of the store on 8 occasions without doing so. So this motherfucker, this cop, working at the store, at the retail store, walks around, picks up a bunch of stuff, brings it up front, says, I'll get that later, and then walks out with it 8 times. But Here's where we get to the kicker, because there's definitely a kicker here. Currently, anything over $750 is considered theft too. In the deputy's case, Zeller, quote, expressed confusion after being hit with the felony organized retail theft charge because he had, quote, never taken more than $750 at a time.
Honey.
Hey, why are you charging me with the big crime? I only took this much at once. It doesn't qualify. So you can't charge me with that crime.
Two things, sir. One, you just fucking confessed, you fucking potato. Which is an insult to the noble potato. But also, you're literally a fucking cop. And you don't know that that's cumulative.
Ionic Assembler says, I work at Home Depot. You're not allowed to confront shoplifters. It's worse when the shoplifter is the police. What the fuck do you do then?
Yeah. And when he's the store security guard.
Right. Well, shit. Do we just let him take it? I don't know.
The working retail is you pretty much have to let people steal.
Yeah.
Not that I would be down for risking my ass for fucking merchandise anyway, but like, it's annoying to just watch shit walk out of the store. And the rationale behind it up at the corporate overlord level is, one, we don't want to get sued by the shoplifter.
Right.
Or two, we don't want to lose a customer.
It's not like we care about your safety. That's not it.
Of not paying.
Yeah.
But we wouldn't want to offend the shoplifters. That would be terrible.
How you charge me with that? I never took that much at one time.
Oh, no lie. And then they're like, oh, so you're confessing. No. I'm sure he was like, what? No, I didn't do it. Bro. Betty Queen's not guilty.
Next up is Tulsa, Oklahoma. And I would think the point of a disguise is you don't want to be recognized, especially if you're doing crime. So maybe don't give yourself, a signature look, which in this case...
Well, I don't do crime.
In this case...
Maybe if all my hair falls out, I can do crime.
Well, the signature look... The signature look in this case, however, is, man arrested after being recognized wearing underwear as a mask in porch pirate cases.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's not so much a mask as a hat. Also, you chose a thong?
A thong. And I love, if you look real close, you can see it's covered the bald spot. The thong is running right through the middle of the bald spot.
It's not even a mask, it's a hat.
Like, there's nothing wrong with being bald. It's just, it's comic that, you know, you've turned your head into a butt.
Yes.
Tulsa police arrested an alleged porch pirate with an unusual and questionably effective mask. They said they were made aware of the porch pirate case in West Tulsa on January 6th. According to Tulsa police, they were private with surveillance images of the suspect. They said an officer recognized the suspect from previous cases where the suspect was wearing women's underwear as a mask. According to the police, they went to the suspect's home, knocked on the door, and saw him. The suspect, Spencer Googler. He remained inside the home and would not talk to officers. Search warrant for the home was obtained inside. All right, that's a funny thing. I ain't got to talk to you. Bye. You need a search warrant. Okay, we're going to get one because you're suspect in and robbery.
Our Googler should have Googled effective disguises.
He was arrested in both for 5 counts of larceny, knowingly concealing stolen property, grand larceny. Number one, can we start off calling these people porch pirates makes it sound way cooler than just, I'm stealing your shit, your fucking Amazon packages?
We have, a lot of package theft in my neighborhood. And the funny thing is, my neighborhood is pretty new, so everyone has doorbell cams. The houses were built with them. These people give not a single dusty fuck. Wow. They will walk right up, shove their face in your camera, and take your shit. I have not lost any packages because I pay off the feral cat mafia to sit on my step and look scraggly and mean. And I don't have any problems. A couple cans of cat food a day solves that problem for me.
What was this like? We're the wet bandits. No, you don't do this shit.
Arrowhead dudes, do you remember during peak COVID, when you had to wear a mask everywhere, that their form of protest was putting underwear on their face?
Yeah.
And they thought they were really sticking it to the man, and we're like, you have underwear on your face. Who really is the loser here?
You are, because...
And you're going to get COVID.
Shut up.
The adult underwear on your face. Nothing is cool about you at all.
Like, were you trying to establish an oeuvre or something here? Were you going for the iconic look? Do you want to be Dennis like...
From the back, he looks like a circus elephant.
Are you trying to become the stupidest supervillain ever? He is the thong. Like, the fuck?
He's already got a theme song. You need to call Cisco, sir.
Jesus Christ. If we call it pants on head stupid, you're actually doing that.
He also chose to wear bright red, which, as we all know, is the color for blending in and burglarizing. I guess I'm impressed that he matched his face thong to his shirt.
I do not want to know where the underwear came from. I don't want to know. There's a story there, and I don't want to be part of it.
It doesn't look like a thong-wearing dude.
Right. So, where...
The dudes you look at and you're like, you wear thongs. He's not one of those dudes.
Not one of those dudes.
He's got a tidy-whitey type of face to me. So where did he acquire a red thong?
Jesus.
Are we believe somebody voluntarily had sex with this person? Because that's upsetting.
And I love the fact that he went around with a fucking pair of underwear on his face and he still got caught.
He had it on his head!
And finally this week, we have one of the most Florida of all Florida stories. I don't really need to elaborate on why as soon as you hear about what happened. Florida man hits officer with car and bites another. There was dancing too, cops say. An Orlando man went on a rampage in a Winter Garden smoke shop Monday, causing thousands of dollars of damage. He then turned on officers, hitting one with a car. Big asterisk there. We'll get back to that. And later biting another, but not before he took a dance to break in the middle of traffic.
Which, by the way, delightful movie. Highly recommend.
Leek Smith, 27, is facing charges of resisting an officer with violence, 2 counts of resisting an officer without violence, battering an officer, failing to obey law enforcement, aggravated battery on an officer, criminal mischief, $1,000 or more, and a partridge in a pear tree. As of Saturday, he was still in jail. Around 7:30 p.m., he went to a mobile gas station and walked over to 592 Smoke Shop, a store inside the fuel stop. Winter Gardens police said he hopped onto the counter and started destroying display cases, causing about $2,000 in damages, and he harassed customers and left. While police were taking statements on what happened, he drove back and then tried to walk toward the store. He ran off when officers tried to stop him. He jumped back into the car, drove around the parking lot before turning toward the front of the store and driving through it. One officer was able to move out of the way, but the other was hit by the car's mirror. So,
That counts
as assaulting an officer. Smith then sped away. So you're sitting here going, oh no, hit a cop. He broke the mirror off on the fucking cop. Come on. About 30 minutes.
Break somebody's arm that way, but.
About 30
minutes. Probably not going to kill anybody.
About 30 minutes later, Officer Joshua Rios was driving to a different call where he saw Smith dancing on the roof of a black Nissan Altima in an intersection. Rios was able to pull him over at a 7-Eleven. Smith walked out of his car, walked into the store, ignoring Rios telling him to stop. Instead of following him inside, the officer waited until he came out and took him to arrest with an assistant canine officer. In the commotion, Smith bit Rios' left thigh, and soon after, canine Maverick was called in to help. He was able to get away from the dog and tried to get to his car. Determined to get there, an officer pepper sprayed Smith, but that didn't stop him. A taser brought him to the ground, where it took four officers and the canine to arrest Smith. That's a Florida Friday night.
You know, up until the bite, you know what this reminded me of?
What?
You remember the Michael Jackson video for Black and White?
Yes, where he just at the, like, okay.
Where he smashes a bunch of shit and then dances on a car?
Kids, I want to just briefly sum up, if you're like, what? Black and White video? Here's what happened.
15-minute video.
Yeah, here's what happened back in the 90s. Michael Jackson, new album, big as fuck. They got The Simpsons to do an intro video to the Michael Jackson video.
The celebrity cameo is, like, huge.
And we have the music, but then the song stops.
Yeah.
And it's followed by another... The song's over. We're done with the song. It's followed by another 5 minutes of Michael Jackson with no music in the background. With Michael Jackson jumping up onto a car and smashing the fuck out of it with a crowbar until he turns into a panther and disappears.
With a dance break.
With a dance break.
Yeah.
You're sitting there going, that's no 10 minutes. I'm not exaggerating. Go look. It's one of the longest fucking music videos in fucking history. It's not a joke. Macaulay Culkin was in it. Yes.
Yeah, he does the rap break.
He did the Macaulay Culkin does a rap. There's a rap break with fucking Macaulay fucking.
The 90s were a crazy time, kid.
You don't even want it. No, it was fucked. Anyway. This guy is also fucked. What happened?
Like, a human bite can fucking kill you.
In the thigh.
Oh, you guys know, the human mouth is fucking disgusting. Like, if you see zombie movies, most of the time, it's not the zombie virus that kills you. It's the human bite that kills you. And then you turn into a zombie. Because the human mouth is disgusting. I don't care how many times a day you wash your teeth, you brush your teeth. It's just a bacteria fucking megastructure in there.
But the fleshy part of the thigh to get a bite. I imagine that officer went up like three octaves.
Isn't there a major artery?
Oh, yeah. There's one that is a big one. And if you hit it, you're dead.
What's it called? No, not the carotid.
Something, yeah.
I think it's an important one.
Four cops and a dog to make you stop. You crash a car into a store You dance in traffic on top of... You hit a cop with your mirror. What the fuck?
This definitely feels like meth.
You know, there's a concept in video games. It's called Find Your Own Fun. It's one of those games where it's like, it's not a very structured game. It doesn't exactly give you instructions on how to get A and B. It's a lot of open world stuff. They call them sandbox games.
The storyteller sucks.
Yeah. So that this is kind of like that. This is Find Your Own Fun, only with the real world.
Yeah.
You're just having a... You're not even on the main quest anymore. You're not checking what any of... You know, no, you're off. You're not trying to get reputation. No, you're off just dancing on cars and biting
people. What's that game we always talk about with, like, the 3-foot dick bat?
Saints Row?
That's the game he's playing.
He's fucking Saints Row, yeah. LARPing Saints Row.
Femoral artery. Thank you.
Femoral, that's the one. Everybody.
Thank you, Sarah.
I love how the channel immediately is like, oh yeah, here's the artery that'll kill your leg that'll kill you if you die. Y'all have really specific interests.
No, there was a football player that died from that. He got stabbed or shot in the leg and he bled out and died.
What happened? You wrecked, drove the car into the spokes. What the fuck, man? And yet,
What went wrong with your day?
It took pepper spray.
Was the gas station out of the purple Mountain Dew, and that was just the last fucking...
Pepper spray, a taser, and a dog to take his ass down.
You see how canine officers work, like, they're trying to fuck your shit up.
And he did not care. Not give a fuck. Also, I love how they refer to the dog, but soon after, Canine Maverick, like, it's a title, they refer to the dog, and then the...
Well, you know, he's the best dog in Top Gun.
How
he made that movie so much better.
If instead of Tom Cruise, it had been a German Shepherd.
Ready? I would see that 17 times.
Somebody out there with Adobe Premiere and way too much time on their hand and some After Effects will bring your wish to life.
If they wanted to, it was very okay. But if Maverick was played by a dog.
I don't know. They have that Owl Kitty on YouTube. And they take the cat, and it's just do that with the German Shepherd for Top Gun. It shouldn't be that long, right?
And you see, years ago, someone did Jurassic Park, where they replaced all the dinosaurs in Jurassic Park with giant cats. Amazing. Best possible way to die.
The first thing we learned this week is you don't have to LARP Saints Row, just play Saints Row. You're not adding to the experience, I promise. In fact, there's shit you can do in Saints Row and you can't do for real.
Like, stick with Guitar Hero?
Sadly to say, copyright is pretty much destroyed Guitar Hero. It's the one game you can't stream on Twitch. Like, flat out cannot do it.
By definition. Copyrighted music.
Yeah. I mean, there's some other stuff you can't do on Twitch, too. Other games, that, like, primarily Japanese games. But mainly the music ones you can't put. We've learned that if you're trying to be a thief in a serial manner, do not give yourself a recognizable trait, especially if that trait is underwear on your head. I think someone's gonna notice.
Balaclavas are not hard to come by, bro.
You could just pull a fucking cornholio, pull your fucking shirt off.
Yeah. We've said this before. We're in an era where it is entirely socially acceptable to wear a face mask. Every place is still selling them.
Yep.
They're not hard to get, and nobody really is going to look sideways at you if you're weird. I mean, it's Florida, so maybe they would.
We've learned that it's not the, as far as it comes to shoplifting, it's not the quantity, it's the quality. And also, just because you're a cop doesn't get to take. It's not going to be like, but I didn't do it all at once. Oh, that's not helping. That's really 8 times.
For your confession.
We've learned 911 is not going to help you steal from people. They're not going to, and they're not going to give you a ride to the airport later.
No.
911 is not a bro. I don't understand how you don't understand. Did they not explain what 911, the point of 911 is anymore?
Like, didn't they teach us that in school?
Right. They had like don't dial this number unless you absolutely have to. They were very, very important about not like, okay, who wants nachos? Dial 911. Ask for nachos.
Like, one's starting to call 911 on me and get me put in Mean Aunt jail while I was babysitting. And it didn't work out. And now he's 17 and driving.
Yeah. I'm sure. Do you remind him of the Mean Aunt jail?
I haven't, but I should.
You should. Do you remember when you were a kid and you threatened to call 911? Yeah, I haven't forgotten. I haven't fucking forgotten.
You were going to throw me in jail. Remember that? Anyway, here's your birthday present.
We've learned that maybe if you're going to try arson, don't be an idiot. In fact, don't try arson, because people who try arson just tend to be idiots.
Or just don't.
Ask yourself, am I an idiot? If you're not sure, you're probably an idiot.
I feel like one of the defining features of being a fucking idiot is having no idea you're an idiot.
That's a good, it's a good chance you're a fucking idiot. If you have to think about it.
Or if you're confident that you're a genius, you're probably a fucking idiot.
And finally, just because the party down the street is having more fun than you could possibly think of having on a New Year's Eve, there is no rationale whatsoever for attempting to set them all on fire.
Or brandishing a machete.
I'll tell you something, as you get older, everyone is going to be having more fun than you. You're not legally allowed to set people on fire for that.
Yeah. Lord knows there are times when I've wanted to.
And Taro on the channel says, ask yourself, is fire a good idea? If you say yes, you're probably an idiot. Well, actually, I mean, sometimes...
You haven't heard about Ash's childhood, clearly.
Sometimes it's a good idea.
Like if you're cold or want to make s'mores.
Or if you have action figures and too much time on your hands.